In the very first video of this week, we learned very briefly about ROS topics. Now we will learn some more important concepts of ROS topics. Let us recall that ROS topics transport information between ROS nodes. Essentially, they are information superhighways in a ROS environment. Information is organized in a ROS topic as a data structure. That is, a topic can be created out of a collection of basic data types, such as strings, integers, floating point numbers, and so on. A ROS topic is defined by a name and a type. A ROS topic can be of a standard type, like the ones mentioned in the previous point, or they could be of a custom type. We will learn more on this in the next module. With this basic understanding of what topics are, let us now focus on a few commands that help us find more information about topics that are being exchanged between nodes. These commands are very similar to those we studied in the previous module with inspecting nodes. As always, when we start a new terminal, we set up the ROS environment by sourcing the workspace setup files. Now, we will learn three commands that help us understand what data is being exchanged between the different nodes. The first command is ROS topic list. This command prints a list of all topics that are being exchanged between active nodes in a ROS application. The second command is ROS topic info topic name. This command prints information regarding the data structure used to store information in the specific topic. And the last command is ROS topic echo topic name. This command prints the contents of the specific topic on the terminal screen. Let us look at them one by one. The command ROS topic list. This command lists all topics by their names, and these are the topics being exchanged between nodes. As we can see, in this example, there are three topics exchanged between ROS nodes. Out of these, the first two are topics internally used by ROS, and the third topic is from the example application. Recall that we had seen this graphical representation of an example ROS application in the previous module with topic underscore one exchanged between node underscore one and node underscore two. Now, the command ROS topic info topic name. In this example, we are finding information about topic underscore one. This command displays the topic data type in the first line of the terminal output. Following this, information regarding which nodes are communicating via this topic is published. In this case, we see that node underscore one and node underscore two are interacting with each other via topic underscore one. And the last command, ROS topic echo topic name. This command continuously prints the contents of the specified topic onto the terminal screen. In this example, the contents of topic underscore one is a string which has the content my first ROS topic. It is relevant to note that the printing continues indefinitely until this command is stopped by pressing Ctrl C. A quick recap of what we have learned thus far. Three utility commands to find information regarding nodes once we have started a ROS application, namely ROS node list, RQT underscore graph, and ROS node info node name. Then, three more utility commands for finding information on ROS topics, namely ROS topic list, ROS topic info topic name, and ROS topic echo topic name. For more such utility commands, you can refer to the ROS cheat sheet in the supplementary documents section of the course. Lastly, a very important detail. There is always a forward slash before a node name or a topic name. This is a ROS convention. So, whenever you are faced with a situation of having installed and started up a ROS application or a ROS demo, you can now keep calm and say, "I got this. I know how to find my way around." See you in the next video.